The band The Stone Roses shone brightly and briefly in the early 1990s, but remain one of the most influential British groups of all time. The Stone Roses album sleeves all featured the distinctive paint-splattered designs of guitarist John Squire, who, 11 years after quitting the band, has now swapped recording studio for artist studio full-time. Tonight, he's launching an exhibition of his latest work, mainly large abstract canvases, at the Smithfield Gallery in London, where I spoke to him earlier today.
I have attempted some figurative work maybe 4 or 5 years ago and learnt a lot from it. I think with the record sleeves, I was obviously imitating a style and didn't really understand the impulse, but I understand more about what I'm trying to achieve.
When you say the record sleeves, you're talking about the early Stone Roses record sleeves, particularly those splattered Jackson Pollock-like drip paintings.
Yeah.
Was that an attempt just to emulate Pollock, or was that your own work?
Yeah, I was copying the technique as faithfully as I could. I assumed it would be impossible to get permission to use those. And I didn't attempt to make contact with the estate.
So you tried your own?
I did enjoy it. Yeah, it was good fun.
Were you therefore trying to create a visual representation of the music that you were making when you were doing those paintings, or even doing the paintings that you do now? Do you see the two as interlinked?
Not so much now. I could see connections between the music I was trying to make and the painting that I loved. I used to listen to music when I was painting. Recently, the last few years, I've much preferred to work in total silence, but there's a real connection between the things I love about music and the things I love about paint. I discovered them at the same time and they promoted each other to me.
So you weren't painting while you were in the when the band started then?
I was working for a living actually when the band started. I was making sets and props for an animation company in Manchester. So I suppose as I was doing it as a day job, it didn't really turn me on at the weekend.
Did you paint as a kid? Were you always artistically driven when you were growing up?
Yeah, I come from that kind of background. Both my mum and dad were quite skillful, creative. My dad made us a lot of toys, but I don't think I've had any sort of real academic background. I was quite intimidated at the thought of oil paint and canvas for a while.
There was no art training, no art school training then, formal training?
No.
The music and the paintings are interlinked in the people who think of the Stone Roses because of those album sleeves, but I presume for you they were very different disciplines. What feels more natural in your hand, the guitar or the paintbrush?
It seems to me that painting comes a lot easier. There's less effort involved.
Easier to create paintings than write songs?
Yeah, it comes more naturally. There's no committee involved. And in a lot of ways, it's more rewarding because there's a faster output, a faster flow of ideas.
But you didn't have to work at those guitar solos, did you, or the way that you played the guitar? Surely that came very naturally, came very easily.
No, I picked up a guitar when I was 14, and I can distinctly remember sitting on the bedroom windowsill playing Three Blind Mice on one string.
The first John Squire solo.
I'm thinking this is going to take a long time.
It's said that there was an acrimonious end to that band. You fell out as a four-piece. Was the tension within the band over the paintings, over the representation of the band in the visual imagery, or was it always embraced by the other members that, you know, you painted the sleeves, this was part of the imagery, this was the Stone Roses?
No, the art had nothing to do with the breakup of the band. The thing that really excites me is the moment of creation, and there isn't a great deal of difference in the way it feels to write a great song or find a great guitar part or start one of these works. That initial impulse is virtually the same. That's the reason I do this, and that's the reason why I made music.
You made music, and you used the past tense there, so are you now an artist who used to be a rock musician?
Yeah.
That's it, the musical career is finished as far as you can see.
That's what I'm trying to say.
Guess that rules out any hope of a Stone Roses reunion then. Former guitarist Stone John Squire's exhibition of his paintings is at the Smithfield Gallery in London. In tomorrow's programme, a review.